Hey, welcome back to the Disney Plus Everyday Challenge, and I have my voice back. Yay! Just in time for us to talk about Read It and Weep. We're in the last day of February. By the way, this is kind of a bit of a milestone. It's not a major milestone, but I mean, this is our 475th episode. And out of those 475 episodes, I have seen 400 new things on Disney Plus that I'd never seen before. Including this. 400 out of 475. Only 75 items are things I've seen before. That's just weird. It just seems unlikely that, but hey, there's a lot on here on Disney Plus. So, also, yeah, well, we can go on to that other stuff later, but this is a 2006 movie. It's an hour and 25 minutes long. It stars Kay Panabaker. You might recognize her from a number of other Disney projects, which we've reviewed here. We've seen her before. But it's based on a book about a girl. I think it's My Personal Journal got turned into a bestseller or something like that. Something along those lines. I probably could look it up, but I won't right now. So, and that's basically the gist of the movie. Kay plays a girl who has a very strong fantasy life, and she writes stories in which she changes the names of the people in her real life to be like what's her name? There was a girl in here, Sawyer. Her name was Sawyer, but she changed her name to Myrna in her journal. So she could talk smack about all these girls who are, the populars, which is, fairly direct name for the popular girls. Not very creative, but either way, it's, she talks about the cliques and the jocks and the dorks and the cool people. It's kind of really cliche, in many ways. But yes, she's a girl who is not very popular. She has a crush on the hottest boy in school, of course. And at the same time, one of her best friends has a crush on her, which he's, of course, not bold enough to speak up about. And she has two other best friends, and everybody's in this journal that she has. And what we see in this 2006 era is a girl who likes to draw on a tablet, a digital tablet. This is very high tech, I think, for 2006. And at some point, instead of dragging the document that is for some report they were doing, I think, for some sort of project, she accidentally is not looking and she grabs her personal journal to email to everybody. Like she has everybody's email, apparently. I don't know. But instead of dragging it to print, to her printer, their project, she ends up emailing the entire school her personal journal. Of course, with all the fake names, nobody somehow is aware that she's the center of this. She's the character is, for I guess short for Isabel, but is or be, it's an active verb, or passive, or it's a verb. Anyway, she's somehow, through this strange accident, becomes a published author, like as if it was that easy. Holy cow. I mean, she's a ninth grader, and suddenly she is a humongously popular writer within her school. Everybody's like crazy about all these characters, especially Iz, who is just so cool and confident, and it's really her alter ego in the story. In situations where she's facing down bullies or the cool girls who treat other people bad, including herself, well, she just, the Iz personality just goes zap zap and they just disappear. So it's kind of crazy. But Iz is not just a, technically a fig, she is a figment of Kay, she plays Jamie. She's not a part of Jamie's imagination, technically, because we get to see what Iz looks like. And is actually, so many Izzes, is a perfect casting choice because is played by Danielle Panabaker, which you might recognize as What's her name from The Flash? She's in The Flash. She's buddies with The Flash half the time, and then she's a villain half the time who's cold. I don't know. Either way, but so you get Kay, who's ninth grader-ish. She's like 15 or so when she's filming this, and then her older sister Danielle plays her more confident, like pretty with makeup and cool outfits and everything else, and she's also like a good foot taller. So yeah, you get this kind of sister act going here. They are, obviously related, and of course is looks so much like Kay that you can see that, oh, she's the ideal version of Kay, the more mature and everything else. So it's kind of it is actually good casting. It's they could have gone with doing that whole double thing where there's a version of Kay playing Jamie that's just normal, and then they could dress up Kay as a cooler, sexier, with better outfits and makeup, and just they could have done her talking to herself throughout the entire film, but they didn't. It was a really good job choosing older sister Danielle to play that role. Beyond all that, though, the movie isn't really anything spectacular. It's not really funny. It's not. It runs through the gamut of cliches. It's not made for me. It's not made for any level of discerning moviegoer. And honestly, this is a Disney Channel original, so it's not gonna blow your mind. It does a good job of telling story, adapting this book. It's a real book, adapting this book, and giving you the story. Everything wraps up in a good, happy ending. It's in the Disney fashion. She's, of course, the beats of a story like this. A normal girl gets famous, then suddenly she kind of gets a little ego, and then something goes wrong in which she's then reviled. Of course, in this situation, we know that eventually everybody figures out that the characters in her book are actually them in her school. And that leads everybody to go, "What? That's me? I'm the dumb guy?" And the evil popular girl reveals that she's the evil popular girl in the book. She finds that out, and now she's going to destroy Jamie. I'm not really revealing anything that you wouldn't have figured out 5 minutes into this film. What I do appreciate, though, is that it's well acted. For a Disney Channel movie, your Kay is believable as Jamie, and her and her sister have great tension between them, because Iz kind of tries to overtake Jamie in some ways and make her act certain ways that she thinks she's supposed to act. Of course, it's all in Kay's head, and honestly, there's points where Kay is talking to nobody and everybody's like watching her. She's a crazy person. That's what they're all thinking. They're all thinking she's a little bit wacko doo-doo. Voodoo, cuckoo wacko at the high school dance. And then there's a thing with a papier-mâché whale that involves saving the whales, but then also seaweed. And there's an awful lot of talk about pizza. And it made me so hungry, and I want to get pizza now. Not with seaweed on it, and not with liver and onions. Her dad runs a pizza place, and I don't know. He just likes to try other types of pizza that nobody would ever want. I don't know. By the way, he's played by Tom Virtue, who honestly he's in every Disney thing. He's in so many Disney things. Look him up. He's a pretty consistent funny dad character in these Disney shows. So anyway, there's subplots with her brother, subplots with saving animals, bunnies, and stuff like that, that honestly just are there just to show that she is thinking only of herself and not of other people. like I said, the acting is decent. These girls seem to be well invested in the characters and not just phoning it in like that last Lindsay Lohan movie we saw a few days ago or weeks ago. I don't even know how long it's been. Oh, it's been a sick month. So, yeah, in this one, I think Kay and Danielle, definitely, and her friends, they all just are realistic. There's a little over the top stuff when it comes to the people who are her, the woman who's her handler, and then also when she gets starts meeting celebrities that she really likes and then is somehow dealing with them on their level. And anyway, it's there's a lot of goofiness in this. Just not like I said, it's not going to be a world-changing great movie whatsoever, but it's not horrible. It's not the worst thing on Disney Plus by far. By far. We know this. We're 475 days into this thing. So just think about 25 more days and we're gonna have 500th episode. Holy cow. So anyway, yeah, Read It and Weep. I think that's the first time I've actually said the name of the movie since we started. And I'm sorry, that's been really late. Read It and Weep is this movie. So yeah, it's nothing I'd say go rush out and watch right now on Disney Plus, but if you need to watch every single Disney Channel movie, original movie, this is should be on your list. And also, if you're a big fan of the Panda Baker girls, here you go. Let's pick tomorrow's episode.
453.
453. Well, that's not too far from where we just were at 444. 453. Hoo-hoo. Oh, so close to a Star Wars. We're in the R's. But we're going to see classic. I think this is the animated 1973 version of a story that's been told countless times throughout history, but this is Disney's animated take on it. Robin Hood. Robin Hood from 1973. I think that's the one. Hopefully it's, like I said, there's so many versions of this, and Disney's done it so many times. I think 1973 Robin Hood is the one with the foxes and everything else. So, yeah. It's animated. All right. Well, if not, we'll just watch the right one then. But yeah. 1973. Robin Hood on the Disney Plus Everyday Challenge. I'll see you back here tomorrow. Bye.